Hey guys, VD Soundtrack Guy here, and I'm super excited to be reviewing Acoustic Samples V-Tines for the UVI Workstation. I have a great relationship with Acoustic Samples now, and I'm so glad that I was able to get my hands on V-Tines. The minute I heard their video overview of V-Tines, I just fell in love. It's an amazing instrument, and I want to get into it. This is going to be a two-part review, first of the UVI Workstation version of V-Tines, and then the iOS version. So I want to go over the UVI version first, and just so much tweakability to start with. Of course, we have all the basic settings on the front panel, but I really like diving into all these other settings, like the amp and the FX. They got wonderful FX section, and of course, you can fine-tune the MIDI to every single note and velocity, and then as well as the actual workings in the back end of the Rhodes, such as the pedal volume and the tine height and all those things. And it's just amazing how much you can tweak on this library. And so I just want to jump right into it. So this is the default sound that we have loaded up here. Unfortunately, the way I have my recording set up, you can't see the drop down menu here. I apologize about that. But I want to play the default sound here. And one thing I wanted to point out too, what I instantly noticed when I played this, is that there is pedal noise. Because I kept wondering, I was like, what is that noise? But it's so authentic. If I push down the pedal just all the way, push it down and then push it back up, you might hear like a sort of like a release sample, like a little click, a little tuck. But if I push it down just a little bit, you hear like sort of like the same noise you would hear with acoustic piano with all the, I think it's the hammers or whatnot lifting up from the strings. I'm not sure if you can hear that, so I want to turn this all the way up. See if I can replicate it. Just pushing down just a little bit gives you that sort of string noise, and it's incredible. And I'm sure that's a feature you can, tweak in the preferences here. But I just thought that was so cool because I was playing and I was like, what's that noise? Because I just pushed down the sustain pedal just ever so lightly and you hear that noise. But all right. Biggest features about this electric piano here is that it's modeled and it only weighs in at 100 megabytes. You could fit this on a 1 gigabyte flash drive many times over. It's crazy, and for the sound that this gives. Get lost playing any good sound. These are some of the demo presets. I guess these are some of the presets that were shown with the UVI's, Acoustic Samples demo videos. So this is amp and DI vibes. But the mod wheel here, you can see, is controlling the intensity of the vibrato. So if you really just want it a little bit there, it's there. But if you want it fully there, you just push it all the way up. I like that. I can get lost in these presets already. Bossa. Thank you. love that vibrato. Let's see, Butterfly. Ooh, that was a little more intense. That'd be nice, like right about here for talk music. Maybe a little bit up more, a little bit more. And if I can do it, is there a chorus on here? I'm feeling a little bit of chorus. Let's see. There it is right there. Just for talk music, you ain't gotta have nothing, you know, really in your face. That's nice. Cheers. Got a little bit of brightness to it. Skip some of these presets here, so I just want to choose some here. Let's do Coffee Break. Yeah, I like that. It's real tacky. You can hear sort of like the keys, I guess, being pressed down. Sort of lost your bottom end on this one, but that's okay. You don't always need the bottom end. Let's see what else we got here. Jazzful. I always socks me. Cause it gets me off guard, that sustain pedal. When you push it down, you hear all those sort of those tines sort of ring off at the same time. That's what I'm talking about. Yep, we got vibrato too. Ooh. I like that. Let's go to, let's see, Power Pop. What's that about? Oh, that's real chorus. We got here. This is the cool effects section. Let's go to Neon Vibrations. That's real 70s flanger type. I guess this is a 70, technically a wah pedal. Some real hard. Ooh, I like that. Ooh. that little the tempo we got going on with that. All right, some custom mods here. These are just deep ties. Really can hear the pedal noise there. Definitely got a bass boost there. Sorry, I forgot any clipping. San Francisco Custom. This reminds me a little bit of a dyno. Let's just adjust our levels a little bit there so we ain't got as much clipping. I bet we can kind of get a dyno sound if we use some of the effects here. To the, some of the preferences here. All notes. Yeah, there we go. Too much bell for some people, but I like that bell. That's real dino-y in my opinion. That's perfect right there. Let's see here. Acoustic session. All right here. So much bell. No, that's what I'm talking about. Oh yeah. I haven't played in church in a long time, so forgive me. I forget all my songs I used to remember. Let's see. Acoustic session. That's the right key for that. I'm not sure what key that's in. I don't even remember what key that's in. Trying to think here. I think it's this one. Like a little bit like an acoustic guitar with all the effects they got on here playing live. I like this. So I think what's trying to be emulated here is, I guess, when you're on the roads and you have it amped up and the amp is farther away out, you know, further from you on stage, you can't really hear it as much on your end unless you're wearing headphones, I guess. So you're mainly hearing the keys being pressed down. That's pretty funny. That's pretty funny. Okay. Let's see. Fury Roads. Oh my. That's wicked. That's pretty wicked. That's wicked. All right. 80s taste. Let's see here. Ethereal Waterfall. Ooh, we're getting fun with the effects now. A little fun preset. Glockenspiel. That's really keyscape like right there. So custom, I guess. Let's see. I guess custom is, I think that's a preset that I saved by mistake. But yeah. But just making your own stuff on here is so much fun. So I want to put up bass just a little bit. And I'm gonna go to the effects. You know I love chorus, so we're just gonna put the depth up a little bit. I can leave it alone right there, but I wanna play with some of the stuff here. So let's see here. Let's do some reverb. That's enough for me. What about some delay? A little too much. About right there is good, but I don't like the mix that much. I just want to hear it in the higher velocities. We get that little delay. Feedback maybe a little bit too much. That's fine right there. Yeah. So when you're hitting like your dominant note, you can hear it, but you don't want to hear it too much with the. You don't want to hear it too much with the chords. So I'll turn maybe this a little bit down. I'm telling you, I love that chorus. And it, makes me want to fall in love all again. That's your talk music right there. It wouldn't have the delay on. That's it. I don't want to. I want to turn up just a little bit. This is the chorus just a little bit, but I feel like it's perfect. So I was going to the preferences here, and this is what I love about this library right here, is that you can edit all the parameters here per note. It's crazy, just crazy. Oh my goodness! So you can adjust the tuning per note. I mean everything. Now I'm not that crazy. I like to do all notes, so I'd probably just turn the bell amount just a little bit. We can hear what time height does. So that's nice. I mean, you're probably about right there at the pedal volume. Now you can hear what I'm talking about. You can hear sort of all that noise whenever you push the pedal down. That's nice. But I want that probably about right there. There we go. Now we're adjusting the attack. But if we're going to do something with talk music, we'll have the attack down a little bit. Got a release volume. And if we have it at zero, nothing. So we'll leave it about right there. Let's see, pickup distance. I think it was about right there last time. We'll put it right about right here. But yeah, got our velocity tones low and high. I don't like to mess with too much stuff because I don't want to mess up the sound I already have. But just lots of tweakability, instantly playable. Let's turn on the amp for a minute. Let's go to the amp stuff. Let's do player. Gives you a whole different sound right there. Player position. Here's the room. Front. Back. I like it with the amp off personally, but I mean, you can just do all kind of stuff here. So this is the UVI version. I think if I ever get back into playing at church again, if I need something with talk music, this is it. Oh. And to think, you know, you got your MacBook, whatever. This is only 100 megabytes, not even a gigabyte, nowhere close to a gigabyte. And you're getting this type of sound. That chorus alone just does it for me. Thank you. while he's playing this key. This is just amazing. Absolutely amazing. So I want to jump up to the iOS version. But this is the UVI version of VTimes. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. All right. We are on the iOS version of VTimes. Already sounding good to start. Let's see. Where am I at on the keyboard? So I can't see exactly where I'm at on the keyboard, but that's okay. So this is VTimes on iOS. Very impressed so far. It seems like we've retained, let's go into preferences, we've retained that pedal noise. So I'm very happy about that. Not sure if you can hear that, but I'll make sure it's up loud after I edit the video. So I'm already happy. Just already happy just by playing. So let's go through some of the presets on this version here. So let's see. Got a few. Not as much as the UVI version, but that's okay. Butterfly. At the default here, and so it looks like we got a minimized version of the effects. There might be more on the iPad version, I haven't checked, but we have the amp we can turn on here. That was actually on already, excuse me. This is what it sounds like dry. For an iPad app or iPhone app, we got the audio settings here just in case you wanted to see them. I got my buffer size at 64 because it can handle it. This is the iPhone 12 Pro Max I'm using right now. Looks like you also got your MIDI CCs too, so you can map for MIDI, which is amazing. Only thing I am disappointed with from what I can see is that I'm not seeing an FX section, which I understand. That can be kind of difficult to emulate on iPhones. I know you need to have a very good framework to work with to get that implemented. I know there is HISE, I believe it's called, H-I-S-E, and they have a good effects framework, but to get it as good as what's on UVI on iPhone is difficult. But what we have here, from what I've seen, is very impressive. I'm very impressed. And it seems like we're dealing with the same exact velocity layers as before. That gives a bit more of a narrower range, but that's fine because you're going to have different velocity responses for different keyboards, and I think this range is suitable for any keyboard. This is sick though. But yeah, let's see here. That's not what I want to touch. I want to go back to the presets here, try out some more. Yeah, all in all, I like this a lot. You can make your own presets here. It got a, you know, a suitable effects section, not as robust or as expanded as the UVI version, but this has a basic Rhodes you need to pull up that's detailed. Kind of missed that chorus. It's playable, and that's, I think, what is the most important part about, especially with iPhone, iPad apps. You don't want to be fiddling around, especially on these smaller screens, trying to get something to be playable, trying to be get something that works. You load up the app, plug in your USB cable to your Lightning to USB to Lightning adapter. And you play. And I love it. I love it. Acoustic Samples did it once again. I think this is one of their first iOS apps, if not their first iOS app. So I'm just wholly impressed. This is great. And yeah, so this is my review of Acoustic Samples VTimes. Just great all around. I prefer the UVI version. I'll take it wherever I go, whenever I play. But if I'm in a tight budge or I don't have room for a laptop or whatnot, iOS version works just fine. I think you can also use the AUM app, the AUM app or whatever, to sort of route this to like a maybe another effects app. I know there's some effects apps out there that you can download and run this through like a chorus. Boom, you're ready to go, buddy. Sustain pedal there for a minute, but beautiful, absolutely beautiful. This is VG Soundtrack Guy signing out, and thank y'all so much for watching this review.